These costumes are very popular. People are using them. They're in great demand. But of course, on the other hand, we struggle to find people who are willing to train in the crafts to make them, to make the silver, to make the special shoes, and to make the special headdresses. And our educational system is not good enough to provide the proper education for these. The proper training, practical training for these crafts. So, on the one hand, the living tradition is strong, but on the other hand, we continuously work to better the condition for the craftspeople involved. Our biggest challenge has always been training and education. And still today, even though you can go to school and get your training, it's problematic since if you really want to be a professional craftsperson, you have to get practical training within a workshop, and it's very hard to persuade different workshops to actually accept students because it takes time and it costs a lot of money, and it's very problematic. So even still today, when we actually experience an increase in interest among young people and among young craftspeople, but it's very hard to get the training and to become a professional, and it's also, I think, very scary for many young people to envision a future where you live as a craftsperson but with very little income because it doesn't pay enough. So these are things that we work to improve, to establish better classes, training classes, courses. We work together with universities and colleges to improve their educational offers. We do research. We publish articles and books to more knowledge about the subject, and we also try to have a dialogue with the government in Norway in order to establish better offers of education. But it's a very slow work. It's very hard, and I think a lot of the young people today that really want to work in this field, they have to be really creative, and often they have to have different jobs to be able to make a living. So it's very sad when people actually want to go into this field of work, and they can't because it's so hard. I don't think there's any one thing you can do. I think you have to do a lot of things. One of the things that we do is that we work a lot with exhibitions, we publish articles and books, and we have school classes here every summer. We work closely with universities so that we have students here every summer who learn from us and work with us. We also bring students with us when we do field works. When we travel around the country, we bring students with us. And we also work closely with other associations and organizations in Norway to have conferences or seminars or practical classes, courses. And so we try to speak as loud as we can and everywhere. And I don't know, we have to do a million different things to make this happen, I think. Also we have to speak with the government and have a dialogue with the government and make sure that they understand the issues that we have. But also it's about reaching the public, which can be hard, but fortunately people are interested and they love their customers. So it is possible, but it's not always easy to reach them, even though we try to. But I think one very important thing is that we have to cooperate. And I think in Norway, we have been not as good as we should have been to cooperate, between the different institutions and the different organizations. We've been all very busy with ourselves, but today we are better at working together, and because we do that, we will also reach more people. Yes, I do. We do see actually that young people today are becoming more and more interested. It has always gone in waves, of course, this interest, and there have been times where the future has not looked very bright. But today we see an increased interest among the young, and I think it has to do with this increased sense of increased concern with the environment, and an increased awareness about natural materials, for example, about quality, about clothes that lasts. And also we see that young people manage to find information in a way that wasn't possible when I was young, for example, because of the internet. Because if they wonder about something, a traditional technique or something, they simply go to YouTube. And one can say many things about YouTube, but it has the advantage that it can connect people that are interested in the same thing. But anyways, we do see an increase today of interest among the young people, both men and women. So I'm definitely positive, yes. I advise you to do research, to register as many variations as you possibly can, and to not only, if you want to revitalize it, not only use one shape or form or one pattern, but use as many as you can, to document as much material as you can. Go to museums, go to, visit different collections, and try to encourage people to use as much variety as they.